gang have been jailed after a man was brutally killed as he enjoyed a coffee in Piccadilly Basin in Manchester. Ahmed Alshran was stabbed in the heart and pushed into a canal amid a city centre brawl. The 33-year-old had been drinking coffee with his brother and a friend beside the Rochdale Canal on the 16th of August 2023 when Mohammed Al-Enizi Hameed approached the group and he asked, "Who are you?" Al-Enizi Hameed then issued a call to arms to a group nearby shouting, "Bring the life, let's do them over." The group was captured on CCTV running to the scene before Mr. Alshran was stabbed in the heart and pushed into the water. Alshran's friend was also stabbed and left with wounds in the abdomen, armpit and lung. In mobile phone footage played to the Manchester Crown Court, Al-Enizi Hameed's group was seen shouting and gesturing at Mr. Alshran's group as he walked away clutching his side. Mr. Alshran managed to climb out of the canal and make his way back to Dale Street but subsequently collapsed. He received open heart surgery at the scene and was rushed to hospital but died after he suffered severe brain damage. A pathologist later found he suffered a deep stab wound to his heart. I just want to say rest in peace to the victim. My condolences go out to your family. Mohammed Al-Enizi Hameed is 36. Faris Hassan is 22. Hussein Mulalal is 20. And two 17-year-old boys went on trial at Municipal Street Crown Court and they all denied murder, attempted murder and alternative offence of wounding with intent. After a 9-week trial, jurors found Al-Enizi Hameed and one of the 17-year-old boys guilty of murder earlier this year. Both were also convicted of wounding but cleared of attempted murder in relation to the friend. Mr. Mulalahal was found not guilty of attempted murder but guilty of wounding, and jurors were unable to reach a verdict in respect of the offence of murder, so not guilty verdicts were recorded. Another 16-year-old boy was cleared of murder and attempted murder but convicted of wounding. Mr. Mulalahal and Mr. Hassan were acquitted of all offences. After a sentencing hearing, on Wednesday, June the 5th, the court heard a poignant victim impact statement from the brother of Mr. Alshran, who outlined the lengthy and agonising journey from switching off his brother's life support machine to getting him back to his home country in Syria. He added, "My brother was a victim of a crime, being stabbed to death. He was innocent. My brother died a victim and he was innocent." Prosecutor Sharon Beattie Casey added, "The evidence showed that they were acting together and they were the aggressors." The court previously heard of the incident on August the 16th last year where Al-Enizi Hameed put his hands into his pocket as if he was reaching for something before Mr. Alshran, his brother, grabbed hold of him. It was at this point he shouted for the others to join the attack, the prosecutor said, and the four individuals ran to the scene and a disturbance ensued. Mr. Alshran was stabbed and pushed into the canal, and it was said by prosecutors that he was stabbed by one of the teenagers and pushed into the canal by Al-Enizi Hameed. He also said that Al-Enizi Hameed was the one who caused the problem as he had approached them first before calling out to the other group to bring a knife. Mr. Alshran's younger brother told jurors of his final moments, adding, "I stayed with him and he said, 'I'm losing my breath, I cannot breathe,' and then he fainted." In mitigation for Al-Enizi Hameed, his solicitor said his client was born in Kuwait and one of the Bidun, who are essentially stateless people and treated as outcasts. He revealed his client was tortured in his home invaded, so he came to the UK to seek some safety. He said the call for assistance was triggered by the fact that he was seized on by the brothers. The court previously heard that Mr. Alshran and his brother took hold of Al-Enizi Hameed after he dived into his pocket in the belief he was going to get a weapon. In mitigation for the team, Imran Shafi, the KC, said the incident was a spontaneous explosion of violence. He added that he had been diagnosed with conduct disorder due to his traumatic upbringing. Sentencing them, the judge, Mr. Justice Pepperell, said it was a bright summer's day when Mr. Alshran, a law student, was enjoying a coffee by the side of the canal in Piccadilly Basin. 73 seconds later, he had been fatally stabbed. The offence was committed in broad daylight in a public area and could be seen by passing pedestrians. The judge said Mr. Alshran was clearly a much-loved young man who was simply enjoying a coffee on a summer afternoon and his life was tragically cut short. So Mohammed Al-Enizi Hameed, he was convicted of murder on Section 18 wounding and he was jailed for life to serve a minimum term of 25 years. The 17-year-old boy, he was also found guilty of murder on Section 18 wounding and he's been jailed for the minimum term of 14 years. Hussein Mulalahal, found guilty of Section 18 wounding, was jailed for 5.5 years, and a 17-year-old boy was convicted of Section 18 wounding and was detained for 2.5 years in a young offenders institution. And in this next news story, and it's coming from the Northwest, a man has been jailed after he was chased and caught by police following a third armed robbery in 6 months. Dylan Rawlinson, who's 24, was part of a masked gang that used an axe, a crowbar and a sledgehammer to target convenience stores in Wigan. His campaign of terror started with the raid at McColl's convenience store on November 19, 2020, just seconds after the store opened for the day. Armed with a sledgehammer and a wooden pole, Rawlinson, together with two other men, forced a member of staff to open the safe whilst also raiding the tills and the cigarette display. He struck again on the morning of Sunday, December the 6th, 2020, at a one-stop shop in Lee. Witnesses described three men wearing balaclavas entering the shop, brandishing a sledgehammer and a wooden axe handle. Unable to breach the time-locked safe, they rifled through the shop's tills and cigarette display before one of the witnesses was attacked with the axe. Rawlinson, together with the two of the men, made their escape just 6 minutes later. Rawlinson was finally brought to justice following an armed robbery at the Co-op in Aspel at around 8:45 on Tuesday, June the 29th, 2021. Witness described three men parking vehicles in the car park of the store before entering and forcing a member of staff to open the safe. Armed with a sledgehammer and a crowbar, they also removed cigarettes from behind the counter and forced their way into the tills. Police were called and recovered the getaway vehicle in Lee shortly after the robbery. The officers then pursued the men on foot into nearby wasteland, and Rawlinson was caught as he tried to escape over a fence and was arrested on suspicion of robbery. Now, Rawlinson has been jailed for 9 years and 3 months after he admitted three counts of armed robbery. After the hearing, Detective Constable Matt Higgum of Wigan Police said this was a complex investigation which resulted in the sentence that reflects the level of aggression and violence Rawlinson used whilst carrying out these robberies. He said innocent shop workers feared for their lives when these men turned up all masked up at their place of business and forced them to hand over money, cigarettes and other valuable products that were in the store. Everyone has the right to go about their day in a peaceful, non-violent way, and getting these men off the streets is a great result for Greater Manchester Police. So guys, there's a number of stories coming out from the streets of the UK. Once again, if you already haven't done so, please subscribe to the channel and please give this video a little like. I'd appreciate it. Once again, big respect going out to each and every one of you. It's your boy GC. Keep it locked, keep it real.